saddle shed and the corral. And the kids are down playing with Seema and Allen's kids, and we're going to take some pictures of the ranch and of the kids playing. I'm Matt Lyman. This is Benjamin Matthew Lyman. He's about 5 months old now. It'd be 4 months on the 12th, wouldn't he?
4 months, yeah. That's right.
He's having a good time being here, as you can tell. This is Kaylin. She just turned 31. Not that you're supposed to know that. Marie Lyman. She's 6 years old. These are the some of the horses as we look across the creek. Just the hill.
The kids
are clear down there. Needless to say, it's a beautiful day today, which we're very fortunate. Sydney. Thank you. what we always refer to as the tobacco patch. The east of the ranch house by the fork in the creek.
there and we'll change your clothes.
Okay. This is the new ranch house that Shimonella built. Their trailer court or house that they've been living in. Looking across the creek from the house, out on the patio veranda that runs around the house. It's very similar to the old ranch house that had a veranda like this. But we could look across and see this very view when we were kids. It's a flat over there.
That changing and then taking it off of
Television Hill. I think that's what they call this. This is the basement of the new house. The basement of the old ranch house used to be right here as well. I remember fun things like an old sharpening stone that we used to play on down here where you sat on a seat and you pedal and turn the stone. We used to hang the deer up down here when they'd shoot them to skin them. Just looking across the street again.
Yeah.
Guys, Yeah!
specifically in. Let's see, this is what day? Tuesday.
Yeah, that's right.
April what today?
14th.
April 14th, we're getting ready to go up to see the big trees.
Miranda?
Up by Arnold or somewhere.
I'm
going
to ride with Laura up to Aunt Levine. You're going to be in there. You going to be okay?
Let's show up.
Let's go, you two. Sutter Creek, picking up the rest of the tribe that's going to the big trees. What's your name? What's your name?
Richie.
What's your name?
Daniel.
Her name's Abby, huh?
Hey, Dana.
This is Morgan.
Well, we're going to make stuff to eat when we go on the trip. Look, there's Cindy.
Well, it looks like we're about loaded to go to the trees.
Walk.
Where are we?
You don't want to walk. You're in big trouble. We are at Calvert's Big Tree State Park for an afternoon of eating, frolicking, and fun.
On April 14th.
April 14th, 1987.
That's Richard.
What's your name?
Richard.
Richard Curran. Tell him. Say Richard Curran.
Yeah.
Spencer and Eddie. Walking along a giant tree that has fallen down. There's Mark and Daniel. Now we're eating lunch before we go out and look at all the big trees.
Just rip. I think you just have to rip it.
Now don't throw your cups away, kids.
Then here's the drink right here.
Let's see, Abby, you need your spoon. There. And you want yours broken too? No? Okay, no. You kids, there's all peppers and carrots and celery.
You know that long one right there? We just run through
it. Wyatt.
Oh, stay out of those right now.
Blaine Wyatt.
Have a donut when you're done eating.
Blaine Wyatt.
Blaine Wyatt and Curran.
One of
Grandpa's birthday. We saved the cucumber.
Haley.
That's from me.
Me!
Now, hey, this is my place.
Yeah.
If you
got Bubble.
Okay. Yes. Would you rather have that than turkey or tuna fish?
No.
I want tuna fish.
I want.
Aunt, can you get me a turkey?
I'm Tony's auntie. Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay, here's
a
turkey. Here's a turkey.
Here's some punch down here.
There's punch down there, too. There's
two. No.
Benjamin.
Okay, Haley wants peanut butter and jelly. How about you, Ray?
This is tuna fish.
Tuna?
Daniel, this is tuna.
Where's plain water?
In the camper.
Okay, orange down there.
Haley?
Okay.
I want peanut butter and jelly.
Anybody want a sweet pickle?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, here's yours.
Yeah, here's yours.
Right there, there's some in there and some in.
Now we're headed out to go through the walk through the Big Trees Park.
This is an automatic.
General Phil Sheridan, this tree is one of the largest in the North Grove. Where is it? Oh. Okay. Let's see. Wait. The very largest giant sequoias are over 300 feet tall and 30 feet in diameter near the ground. Here in this forest of giants, this may not seem impossibly large, but try marking out these dimensions in your living room, at home, or on the school playground in an urban setting.
How wide are they?
30 feet wide. Over 300 feet tall. Deciduous broadleaf dogwoods. and hazelnut shrubs in this area. You know, note that? Heavy rains, particularly in the springtime, can flood this entire area. Remember when we came and it was, we had to jump around the puddles?
Oh, yeah.
Try to imagine this forest in other seasons. In midwinter, for instance, when 4 to 6 feet of snow may cover the ground for months at a time.
Six right here. That's
that tree.
Look
at that.
Apple core.
Baltimore.
Number six.
Again. Okay. Six. The massive vitality. No throwing rocks at the giant. The massive vitality of giant sequoia is clearly evidenced by the way in which this large tree is recovering from a serious fire and other damage occurred long ago, perhaps hundreds of years ago. Note how the bark is trying to cover the scar burn.
There's a chimney.
There's a chimney.
Trees. You know what they call this? They call this the pioneer cabin tree. Is that part that fell off of there?
I don't know.
Okay. During the 1880s, this tree, the pioneer cabin tree, was cut through as a piece of showmanship designed to offset the growing fame and popularity of Yosemite's two sequoia groves. One road at Yosemite passed right through the slightly smaller but much photographed Wawona tree, which was hollowed out in much the same fashion. Walk through the opening and notice the whole top of the pioneer cabin tree has broken off and now lies on the ground where it is slowly decomposing.
Matt, you need to manufacture an 18-wheel red wagon.
Yeah.
Part of the grove. That must be right. 10 or more.
On the western slope of the Sierra Nevada, this giant sequoia still survives and still plays the dominant role that they and other redwood species play throughout the northern hemisphere during that warm, moist time when giant reptiles, dinosaurs stalked the earth.
Okay. They were
live then.
Yeah.
Wow. Whoa.
Okay. Want to have it sit down right for a minute? Think it'll still be there in the millennium.
gone though. Okay, Mother of the Forest. This fire darkened snag. They didn't say hag. Snag was once a very large and handsome giant sequoia. In the summer of 1854, that was 100 years before I was born. However, a group of speculators, unrelated to those who had fared so badly with the discovery, erected a scaffolding and stripped this tree of its bark.
Oh, that's see, if you look up there, you can see where the chainsaw is, where they cut it in strips to take the bark off of it.
Okay, carefully labeled and packed, the bark was then shipped around the Cape Horn to the East Coast, where it was reassembled as the main attraction of the New York City Crystal Palace exhibit of 1855. In 1856, the bark was shipped to England, where it was given a place of honor in London's largest exhibit hall, also known as the Crystal Palace. Both in New York and London, the 116-foot-high exhibit was a spectacular success, although there were many people who even then deplored the destruction of the soul of so noble a living organism.
They took
all the bark marks and other scars made by the bark collectors are visible to this day, but the charred but enduring heartwood of this old giant.
So why doesn't that fall down?
I wonder.
It might. Uh-oh.
I know.
That's so you can sit back here and go, whoa.
What if it fall, Mommy? Will it make it?
They can
boys, come on, don't be beating the trees.
Kurt Lewis carved his name around the other side up there in one of those places.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's a two one in. In here.
Those are wild. Huh? The black ones?
Well, they look like the black.
What are you doing? Zooming in on them?
Mm-hmm. I better not need them on your shoes.
Thank you.
Another tunnel.
You have the keys to your vehicle.
Ages and monumental rather than alive and growing. Nevertheless, except in the coldest part of winter, the tree is busy in all of its many parts. Its roots reach out 150 to 200.
I'm standing on.
Don't go through there. You can't go through there. Stuff can fall on you.
We're at the Lyman Alder Grove Ranch and we're on top of TV Hills. We're going to roll the tires down. And this is Wednesday, April 14th. 15th.
15th. What year?
15th, 1987. My name is Adam Ashby Lyman.
And how old are you?
And I'm 10 years old.
Okay.
My name is Eddie Lyman. I'm 8.5 years old.
My name is Brett Lyman, and I'm 7.5 years old.
My name is Gregory Lyman, and then I'm 8 years old.
My name is Mark Lyman, and I am 10 years old.
And I'm Brett.
I'm Eddie.
Okay.
My name is Seth Lyman. And I'm 7.5 years old.
My name is William Gregory Lyman, I'm 12.
I can't even remember it.
Shane.
My name's Shane Justin Lyman, I'm 11.
I'm Daniel.
Tell us your name, Daniel.
But I'm Pee Wee Herman.
Tell us your name and how old you are.
He always laughs.
You've already done me. Ah, a wheat bed. Digging for gold. Ah. This is kind of a gold mine.
This is a gold mine.
Honeysuckles. This is a honeysuckle.
Oh, watch it jump that ditch.
Yeah! That ditch is